Well, it's good to be able to share the word together today. Wow, what a lead up to Christmas this year. There's been so much going on, and all of us have been affected in some way. We're trying to come to grips with what is going on in our world right now. But here's the thing, it's Christmas time. It's the festive season. It's the time of year where we celebrate good news of great joy for all people. The coming of Jesus into our world, the arrival of the Son of God, the Savior, the Messiah, the light of the world. Why don't you nudge someone right next to you now and say, it's Christmas time. It's time to celebrate Jesus. And we're going to dive into the Christmas story this morning and look at Luke chapter 2. If you've got your Bibles there, you can grab that now. Luke chapter 2. Just as we turn there, I want you to think about this question. What are you watching this Christmas? What has your attention and focus? Well, Luke chapter 2, verse 8, it says this. And there were shepherds. Stop there. Those four words. Look at them again. And there were shepherds. Those four words are central, integral, at the very heart of the Christmas story. There's no Christmas story without the shepherds. It says, and there were shepherds. We sing songs about them, Christmas carols. They appear on Christmas cards. We know the picture of the nativity scene where these shepherds are there surrounding Jesus in the manger. And there were shepherds. But we've got to understand about being a shepherd. It wasn't a sought-after career path. People didn't aspire to be shepherds. It was considered a lowly job. It was hard work, long hours, little pay. It was dirty. It was smelly. There wasn't much to smile about being a shepherd. And there were shepherds living in the fields nearby. Stop there. Living in the fields. Did you catch that? Not only was it dirty and smelly and hard work, long hours, they lived in the fields with the sheep. You know, I don't know about you, but at the end of the day, I like going home to my warm, comfortable bed. But these guys, these shepherds, they camped out in the field. There was no going home to a nice warm bed. They slept right there among the sheep, protecting them, watching over them. The shepherds spent their time watching the sheep. It says, and there were shepherds living in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. We all watch things. We're all watchers. There are things that take our attention and our focus every day. Some of us, we like to watch TV, we watch the news, we've been watching alert levels, 1 p.m. updates. We watch the kids, we watch sport, YouTube, TikTok. Some of us watch the share market. There's all sorts of things that we spend our time watching. At Christmas time, there's certain things we watch even more. We watch how much we spend. We watch what we eat. We watch our weight at Christmas time. When we drive off to go away on holiday to be with family, we watch our speed as we're driving. There are all sorts of things that we watch. Much of what we watch these days, or this generation watches, is on screens. We spend a lot of time watching screens. I mean, you're watching one right now. But here's the thing. If there is a young person watching today, a reality check about these shepherds, they didn't have devices. There were no screens. They weren't lying back in the fields with their sheep, scrolling through TikTok. No, they didn't have screens. They spent their time watching their sheep. They were captivated by the sheep. This was their lives, watching over the sheep. But something was about to happen that would cause them to look away from the sheep and look in another direction. And this was a big deal for the shepherds to take their eyes off the sheep. So what happened? Well, let's have a look at verse 9. It says, and an angel of the Lord suddenly stood before them, and the glory of the Lord flashed and shone around them. Well, that would do it. I mean, I'm sure that would cause you to look away from whatever you're watching and look towards the light. It flashed and shone around them. Their lives were about to change forever because they looked in another direction. They changed their focus. They took their eyes off the sheep. For you and I, sometimes all we have to do for our lives to be changed is to look in another direction, is to change our focus. Paul de Jong, he says this, your focus will determine your future. In other words, what we focus on, what has our attention, determines where we're heading. What are you focused on this Christmas? Well, for these shepherds, as they look towards this light, God shares this most amazing, exciting news with them. He says this, I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. Good news of great joy, not low-level joy, not even mediocre joy, great joy for all people. This was for everyone, whoever would open their hearts to this. This was the good news. And so what did the shepherds do when they see this light and hear this message? Verse 15 says, the shepherds said to one another, let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about. So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in a manger. They hurried to see Jesus. They ran. This is how much it impacted them. They dropped everything they were doing and they hurried off to find this baby Jesus. And I know what you're thinking right now. You're thinking, but what about the sheep? What about the sheep? Well, what did they do with the sheep? Did they, as they hurried off, did they bring the sheep with them? Or did they say to the new guy, Tommy, say, Tommy, we're just heading away. You can watch over the sheep. We don't know. All we know is that they hurried off to Bethlehem. And here's the thing at Bethlehem. Bethlehem was crowded. It was overcrowded. It was inflated in terms of the number of people there because of the census. And so when they arrived at Bethlehem, did they just go door to door, knocking on every house, looking for a baby? We don't know. But what we do know is that they did not give up looking until they found him. They kept looking until they found Jesus. And then verse 17 says, when they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said. Once they had seen him, when they had seen him. See, one minute they were watching sheep, the next minute they are looking at Jesus. When they had seen him, after they had set their eyes upon Jesus, upon the Messiah, the newborn king, what they did next was they went out and they told everyone about him. Their lives were changed because they saw Jesus, because they looked upon Jesus. Before they could see Jesus, before the shepherds could see Jesus, they had to take their eyes off the sheep. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 2, some of you may know this verse. It talks about the writer is calling us to fix our eyes on Jesus. The Amplified Translation expands it out a bit and says, looking away from all that would distract us and focusing our eyes on Jesus. You see, before we can really fix our eyes on Jesus, we've got to look away from things that would distract. If we really want to see him this Christmas, we must first look away from the things that could distract us. Maybe worries and concerns, challenges, difficulties. Look away from the things that might be weighing you down and look towards Jesus. Fix your eyes on him, the light of the world, this Christmas. What is it that you and I need to look away from to really see Jesus this Christmas? Is it busyness? Is it worries and concerns? Maybe it's fear and uncertainty. I want us to shift our focus this morning, just for a few moments, to look away from all that other stuff and focus on Jesus for a few moments, right where you are. And we're going to sing a song, we're going to share a song with you that would help you do that. But before we do that, before we sing, let's pray together. Let's pray. Father, this Christmas, as we lead up towards the celebration of your birth, we pray that your light would shine upon us, that you would consume our focus, that we would look away from anything and everything that is weighing us down, that is distracting us, the difficulties, the challenges, and we would fix our eyes on you. We would fix our eyes on you. Help us to do that this day. Help us to allow your light to shine into our lives as we look to you this morning, I pray. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen.